Hey guys, it's Joyce here with thebikinikitchen.com, author of the Bikini Kitchen Cookbook. And if you haven't got your copy yet, make sure you head on over to thebikinikitchencookbook.com. It's football season, it's comfort food season, and nothing like sweetens the ending of a football game better than some good old-fashioned chocolate chip cookies. But we're going to make it with a healthy twist, of course. It's going to be totally gluten-free and could be nut-free with the option of not doing the chopped pecans in the recipe. So, I've been in the kitchen all day. It's a little bit hot, I might be sweating. So what we're gonna need is some baking blend Truvia. This is really amazing. They've taken the Truvia and ground it down really fine, and a half a cup of Truvia gives the sweetness of one full cup. So this is amazing, and you don't have to worry about all the extra calories. I have some veggie butter spread. It's not, you know, animal fat in here. It's soy-free. I think it's dairy-free. Yeah, dairy-free. It's amazing. We have some dark brown sugar. Now, we're not going to use as much of this, but we will use a little bit to give that texture to the chocolate chip cookie. And I have some mini chips. Now, these are not regular milk chocolate chips. And they are dairy-free, nut-free, and soy-free. So they're free of all the garbage that you find in chocolate chips these days. So this is amazing. And then optional, of course, we have chopped pecans. And this is just for added crunch and texture. And then I have my different batches of flour. I'm going to go through that step by step with you. And also some eggs. But hey, let's get started. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to add our brown sugar to the bowl. Okay, next up we'll add the Truvia. Alright, next up we're going to cream the sugars together with the butter mixture, and I'm just going to use my spoon and combine those well. I'm just going to add a little dash of water to this now, and about a capful of vanilla extract, and we'll mix that together. Alright, next up we're going to get our flour blend. You guys know that for gluten-free baking, I like to use tapioca flour, potato starch when necessary, brown rice flour, and coconut flour, right? Coconut flour is a little bit too cakey for the chocolate chip cookie, so we're going to omit the coconut flour on this one, okay? But we are going to use the tapioca, and we're going to use the potato starch and a little bit of brown rice flour. So I'm going to go ahead and get that started. All right, first up is potato starch. And what that's going to do is add some crisp crunch to the outside. After that, we'll do brown rice flour. And that's going to give that density to the cookie. And finally, we're going to do the tapioca. All right, just a pinch of salt here. Next up is the baking soda. Baking powder is next. All right, so now we'll mix up all of our dry ingredients. Now we'll take our creamed sugar and butter mixture with the vanilla and a little bit of water, and we'll add it to our flour combination. All right, next up we're gonna add our mini chips in here. And you're just gonna do this to your liking. I'm adding about a cup. So I like chocolatey, chippy goodness. And we're just gonna mix that in and allow it to sit for just about 10 minutes. Because again, when you're using like a gluten-free mixture, you want to allow everything to absorb and kind of set for a moment. So we're just going to allow this to sit for about 10 minutes. All right, guys, so now everything's mixed up. The cookie mix has been set to the side. Chocolate chips are in. We're ready to go. Now, what I did was I put the pecans on the side so I could make half of my chocolate chip cookies with and half of them without. That's just in case anybody has any nut allergies. So you just want to get about a good size spoonful, drop it down on parchment paper so they don't stick. And I'm going to keep adding these to my tray, and I'll be right back. All right. right, so my oven was preheating at 375. My cookies are in there and they're going to bake for about 18 to 20 minutes. Now again, my oven is electric, so the cooking time is going to be a little bit shorter, but just make sure that you keep checking it and making sure that your cookies are cooked all the way through. When you start to see the browning on the top, that will let you know as well. All right, I'll see you in a minute.
The cookies are done. I'm getting heckled in my own house over my cookies. They're delicious. Let's take the potato starch added the crispness. Chocolate chips are just right. This is going to go great with some ice cream. If you love this video, share it with your friends. Pin it, tweet it. Do everything you can to let people know about this is really good. TheBikiniKitchen.com. I'll see you next time. Bye. Alright guys, so the cookies are done. And they're crispy and crunchy. I picked the most burnt looking one.